everybody. Good evening, members. Good evening, officers. And may I say good evening to all those people who are sitting out there in the gallery. Good evening, everybody. And can I just
smile?
You can't hear me.
Can't hear you.
I'll try and speak a bit louder then. The microphones aren't working all right. Can I just remind the members in the public gallery at the back there that this is a private meeting held in public. So I don't want people shouting out at any juncture of the meeting, and I will deal with people who do. So please, I ask you, please keep your comments to yourselves. If you want to speak to any of the committee after the meeting, you know, the committee, when we're trying to get home, I know I will certainly facilitate anybody who wants to ask anything on what we covered tonight. So would you please bear that in mind. Thank you. Now we'll start the meeting. No, sir. It's not that sort of meeting. You can't raise your hand and ask a question. You're only here to observe. Okay.
No.
Thank you. Any apologies for absence?
Thank you, Chair, Councillor John Hairlander, Sergeant Forward.
Thank you.
Members' Code of Conduct, have you got any declarations of interest?
I didn't switch out. Have we got any declarations of interest? Yes.
Yeah, Chairman. Like many members who attended the workshop a few weeks ago, I made my views known on the introduction of parking charges I was voting on, as did many members. Move back. And I would ask everybody to refrain
from lifting chairs. We've got a health and safety issue in here, and that's if I have any outbursts like that again, we've got an officer from the council here. I will ask people to leave. I will. So please be quiet and let's get on with the meeting. Rosemary.
Okay, thanks, Chair. So good evening, everyone. This is the latest update.
Oh, this will be some
time. Just a brief overview of the most recent developments.
Chair. If I can, clearly the microphone system is very poor.
Yeah,
a lot of feedback. Can we have it fixed, or we have to, you know, not listen?
I apologise for this. We are doing our best.
Alliance, keep on obviously we're working hard to make sure that those interests and priorities around the plan pledges are on the ETA City Region developments. So that's ongoing activity really. And
once again, Rodney, thanks very much. Are there any questions from the committee on Rodney's report, Dave?
Just one, Chair, please. It's in relation to the business rate pilot. It's a question I ask regularly in relation to this. We know that the funding we get from central government at the moment is top-end sliced. When we go through this pilot, will we still receive the same amount, or will we have a financial gap between what we raise and what we raise?
So we don't have the details of that yet, but that's obviously part of the ongoing negotiations to try and secure that we're actually disadvantaged, but we don't have the detail yet. It's still ongoing discussions with the government.
Okay, thank you.
Anyone else? Right. Thanks, Rosalind. Thank you. Get off home.
Given the amount of the public here and the, clearly the public interest the parking charges issue has generated, could I ask that we move this item 5 off the agenda in order that the people can hear before we deal with other business?
I actually think that's perfectly acceptable. Do all the committee agree on that?
Agreed.
Because of the amount of interest, I think that's perfectly acceptable. And I don't think the leader of the council will mind waiting till after we move this up the agenda. Okay, so we'll now go to agenda item 5. I'll vacate my seat again because the microphone there is not working. Okay. Rob Clifford's now going to this item, please, members. This item's been added to the agenda tonight because we had a pre-scrutiny workshop a few weeks ago. Now, can I reiterate tonight, all we're talking about at this committee tonight are proposals that have been made from the officers. Nothing more and nothing less. There will be no decisions about anything made tonight. So we are only discussing, which came on from the excellent meeting we had, and I do agree this is a contentious issue, and that's why it's been added to the agenda tonight. But I'll reiterate once more, there are no decisions at all being made tonight. Thanks, and this is now Rob Clifford, an officer from the council, who will now give his report, and then I'll invite members of the committee to ask questions. Now, can I say, a lady's got her hand up there. This is not a public meeting. We're here to discuss the agenda which is on our committee tonight.
Have we used public servants?
This is not a public meeting. I've asked people not to shout out. If they do, and they continue to shout out or raise their hands, I will ask them to leave. This is Rob Clifford, who's now going to present his report.
Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
I'll do my best to keep up with this level of voice all the way through so that everybody gets a chance to hear what I'm going to say. Thank you very much, Chair. This presentation follows on from the workshop committee that you asked at that meeting for more information around the details behind the assumptions made in making the calculations. So I propose to go through the three proposals in detail. The first proposal is to increase tariffs of all council operated car parks by 50p. The assumptions we have made in assessing the savings to be made for the 2017-18 budget is that the total number of tickets forecast to be sold during the current year is 854,000. This will has enabled us to calculate that the saving will be at least £400,000 in 2017-18. The second proposal is to introduce car parking charges at country parks in the borough. proposal to introduce charging at country parks in more detail. The affected parks are there on the screen map as Arrow, Country Park, Eastern, Royden, Wirral, and Birkenhead Park will be introduced in 1819. The proposal to introduce charging has been based on assessment of the number of estimated spaces and the number of visits per year that we know about. There will be potentially less people using the car parks, and this has been factored into the calculations, as well as an allowance for our expected startup costs of introducing equipment and the running costs of that equipment and enforcement. The third proposal is to introduce charging at locations where parking is currently free. So it is proposed initially to introduce parking charges at the Fort Perch Rock car park and on street along the marine promenade in New Brighton, which we think would raise an income of £130 in 2017-18. It is also proposed to introduce parking charges at other car parks and certain on street town and village centre locations where parking is currently free of charge, raising a further £370,000 in a year. The calculations have been based on the average income per parking space being £400 per year for both on and off street parking spaces. I'll now run through each of the town and village centre location proposals. So for New Brighton, the Fort Perch Rock car park has been assessed based on 180 spaces and our current estimate of 30,000 visits a year. This would generate income of 70,000 a year. Green Promenade, Town Promenade and Victoria Parade have been assessed based on 150 spaces, generating income of £60,000 per year. For West Kirby, the estimate is based on approximately 150 spaces on the following roads: South Parade, Banks Road, Crescent and Grange Road. The possible income identified from that proposal is £60,000. For Hoylake, the estimate is based on approximately 100 spaces on Marley Street, Station Road, Albert Road, Charles Road Car Park and Car Lane Car Park. The possible income there is estimated at £40,000 in a year. For Heswell, the estimate is based on approximately 100 spaces on Telegraph Road, High Road, The Mount, May Road, Milner Road, Rocky Lane South Car Park, with a possible income of £40,000 per year. The proposal at this car, the estimate is based on approximately 150 spaces on Seaview Road, Liscard Village, Wallasey Road, Mill Lane, Liscard Road, and the Manor Road Car Park. The income expected is the order of £60,000 per year. The proposal to Bromborough is based on approximately 100 spaces on Orpall Lane, Bromborough Village Road, High Street and the Orpall Lane car park, with a possible income of £30,000 per year. Proposal at Bevington, the estimate is based on approximately 100 spaces on Bromborough Road and the Church Road car park, with a possible income of £30,000 per year. The proposal at Early is based on 100 spaces approximately on Thingwall Road, Manor Road and the Roslyn Road car park, with a possible income of £30,000 per year. Proposal at Upton, the estimate is based on approximately 100 spaces on Brake Lane and Arrow Park Road. The income is estimated possibly at £40,000 a year. The final proposal is more where the estimate summary for the three proposals together, the income generated and for savings to the budget expected to be, as set out in the slide, increasing the tariffs by 50 pence, £400,000 next year, country parks, £200,000 next year, New Brighton and other locations, £250,000 next year, a total income for the 2017-18 budget of £850,000. The 2018-19 budget proposals total £450,000, generating a total budget saving by 2018-19 of £1,300,000. Chair, those are the details behind the proposals as requested by the committee workshop.
Thanks, Rob. I think it would be agreed that there's detail in there that we didn't have at our last meeting, so I thank Rob for that. I'll now open the debate up to members to ask Rob any questions on the report that he's just given. Chris?
Thank you, Chairman. As you alluded to, the detail we have now, I'm disappointed we didn't have earlier. I'm disappointed it was withheld from the elected members until last Wednesday, while being made freely available to the press on Friday. And I found that to be absolutely unacceptable. And even when I requested the details, having made you aware that we've made available to the press, you continued to withhold the chair, saying it wouldn't be available until the 18th. When we saw the traffic regulation order dated the 18th, we fully understand why that was now. Because this traffic regulation order was available at the workshop. We weren't made aware of it. The information on parking spaces for the other town centres was available, although we were only given the headlines. I find the whole process of bringing this out into the public domain to be particularly secretive, shall I say, there's a polite way of saying it, and one that we shouldn't have to go through again. And I would implore you as chair to ensure that officers of this committee act with propriety next time, provide the information we're asked for to members and not just to the press. I'll then go on to a couple of questions if I may, Chair. There's a point I might come back later. Rob, thanks for the presentation again. You painted it, as you did at the workshop, as three proposals. Is this three proposals to be taken as one, or is there a choice of taking either of the three? Because at the workshop you said the three proposals will be taken as one. Have you, you talked about you factored in a loss of usage because of bringing in charges. What factoring is that? How much do you expect to lose because of that? Have you carried out any impact on what will happen to the side streets where parking remains free, which are already under stress and strain, particularly, I'm sure around the border, but particularly in Bolton? Has any impact been carried out on what will happen to the traffic that is displaced? And Chair, I find it particularly galling that we're talking about introducing all these charges when, in the Wirral News, only last Wednesday the 18th, the same day as the traffic regulation order was published, keeping our high streets, this is from the Leader of the Council, where he says, keeping our high streets thriving and busy with shoppers is a key pledge, and our plans to regenerate our town centres.
That's a good one, isn't it?
We'll see innovative and imaginative development projects for our shopping and commercial districts. We're also making progress on the golf resort in Hoyleck and proposed improvements in resort towns such as West Gary and New Brighton will support our growing tourism sector and attract more visitors and new local business to the north and the west of the peninsula too. Well, Chair, that's great and I fully support that. But bringing in parking charges at our shopping areas and our country parks on top of those for free will do nothing to enhance the shopping experience in our towns. And if that's what the Leader of the Council believes is innovative and imaginative then I hate to think what else you've got planned for the people this put out.
Statutory notice, which
three, there's one proposal with three.
Can I just come in there?
Yes, sir.
Rob, please. The members of this committee can decide tonight whether we take it as one proposal or the committee as a whole want to take it as three separate proposals. Okay? Thanks, Rob.
The second question then was the assessment of what we thought might be the reduction in use of country parks. In our calculations, we've made the assumption 30%.
30%.
On the question on the impact on side streets and displaced traffic, there's been no detailed assessment of that yet. The final question about thriving high streets. The position that we're proposing for these, this proposal, is about the budget for 2017-18. The business case that I'm supporting the proposal is purely addressing the budget gap. Thank you, Chair.
Thanks, Rob. Gerry.
Thanks very much, Mr. Chair. I firstly want to say I'm not complaining to the officers at all. They've been asked to do a job for you and they've done that job for you. So I've got no criticism of the officers. It's the people that doesn't control the officers, that's the cabinet and the leader, etc. I think that you have the cabinet made a desperately serious error here. I think that they haven't thought out, and officers haven't obviously told them this year, that there's going to be some very, very serious repercussions if these proposals take place. The first thing that really worries me is it will kill off our shopping centres.
Yes, it will.
I'm sure it won't throw you out if you clap, folks, so don't worry too much about shopping. The leader himself, who's sitting at the end of the table, if you don't recognise him, by the way, any of you people down there, the leader himself has said that, probably wasn't, but he's still there, the leader himself has said that there are serious dangers for shopping centres. Rob, you've no point in shaking your head. We know. Can we believe
it? Gerry, would you address your comments to me?
Sorry, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
There are serious dangers for our shopping centres. This has been illustrated by the fact that you've made generous concessions to Birkenhead because it was in particularly serious need. And that's an excellent idea. So if we do these things to our shopping centres, the public will flood out away from them. And they'll go to the supermarket where they can get free parking for 1.5 or 2 hours. And that will mean that many of our smaller shops will go have to close down. And that's tragic. I represent Hoylake and part of West Kirby. And there are some shops I know there, because I see them regularly, that are on the edge of being able to stay in business. And if these car parking restrictions come in Market Street, Hoylake, or Bank Street, or West Kirby, we will see shops closing. And you will see business rates disappearing, and you're losing lots of money from businesses which are closing down, and that's very sad indeed. Now, also, the residential seats close to our parking centres can't stand any more at parking than they're getting at the moment. And obviously, if people can't park as they do at the moment on the main road and in the main, or don't want to because they don't want to pay, then our side streets are going to be absolutely chock-a-block, and this is going to cause. And you must have thought this out. I can't believe that Phil Davis and his colleagues haven't thought this spot out. Fact is, what's going to happen to our shop? Now, a lot of people say, let's have residential parking schemes. Well, that's a separate issue, of course. They may well have to consider that. But they have their own tremendous problems, like, for example, stopping people, legitimate people from parking when the resident isn't there. There's a waste of space. Now, this country parks proposal is absolutely horrendous. It's diabolical. It's ridiculous. Our cabinet, our leader tells us that encourage people to get out onto the countryside. At the moment, many people are going out, taking their dog out for a walk or taking themselves out for a short jog, etc. And to ask them to pay £4 every time to do that, they're going to be spending £20, £30, £40 a week on what at the moment they can do free. So it's absolutely essential that you forget this idea of charging on country dogs. We've just been told by our officers that some anticipated 30% in reduction in the use of country dogs. That is horrendous. That's 30% of the people not going out for the exercise which we want them to have. It's terrible. It's a very great mistake. Now, you know, Phil, you know, that there are plenty of ways that the council can save money if they're desperate. For example, they can scrap some of the simple things they've done in recent months. Like, for example, your London newspaper.
I'm allowing you great latitude here, but please don't bring other issues in. We're talking about car parking charges here. So please,
okay,
don't bring other issues.
All right, I promise I won't mention the golf.
Particularly the committee, why we are looking at these proposals. Thank you, and thanks for your comments, Jay. And now we move on to Dave. I've got you after Dave, Tom.
Excuse me, you can't throw me out because I'm going. But if it's only a proposal, how come notices have already gone up in our own country park? It's on Facebook.
Thank you, Chair. I was, like Ron, I thought you were next, and of course, reading my mouth, excuse me. Three questions, but first of all, I'd like to make a few comments. I agree with the comments that you just made, but I also agree with the comments that the Director, Dave Armstrong, made in relation to what was asked for and done by the members of this Select Committee when we had our previous meeting on this particular issue. I've got no complaints or arguments about it. The process and the way things have been dealt with. Things that have come to mind and come about in relation to the effect this will have on surrounding areas, to the areas that are affected in relation to the car park. One thing that surprised me more than anything was when we had our briefing meeting, I thought New Ferry Car Park was in there as well, as Grove Street. For some reason they've disappeared at the moment. Maybe that's got nothing to do with the local MP. Objecting to this proposal, I wouldn't have an idea. The thing that comes to mind more than anything else is the information that we get from people who've objected prior when we've tried to do this before. My first question for the officers is in relation to the Section 55 RTA RA amended in 1984 in relation to local authorities using car parking to raise revenue. Now, given the statement that was made earlier on, that this is to bridge the budget gap, in my mind, that is raising revenue through car parking charges. I would like to know where we stand legally on that particular issue in the first place. But when I go on and say that two of the major parks that we've got, one of the ones that we spend most of our money on, which is Thursday, and one in my ward, which is one of the first in the country, which is Eastern Country Park, are actually on the end of two of the longest cul-de-sacs that we have on the Peninsula. So the effect that will